All right, good people. So today we're breaking down the R&B classic Love TKO by Teddy Pendergrass. Let's get it. So good people, Love TKO. The key of this song is in B natural. So we have in the scale of B natural, the major scale, we have B, C sharp, D sharp, E, F sharp, G sharp, A sharp, and then B, okay? All right, so we're gonna divide this song into two teachable sections, all right? The first section is gonna be our intro and our chorus. They are both the same. So the progression that we do for the intro and the chorus are the same. And then the second section, of course, will be for your verse, all right? So let's start with the left hand for the intro or the chorus. All right, so this is what we have. I'm gonna play it in time, and then I'll break it down. One, two, three, four. 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 Okay? And so, basically, now, this is kind of the baseline, pretty much. The bass line also does different ad-libs leading into playing the C sharp. So technically the C sharp starts on the one. So the lead in starts on the four. So it's like one, two, three, four, one. So it's like G sharp, A sharp, B, D sharp, and then C sharp. Now the way I finger it, I go middle finger, index, thumb, index, middle, and then I do a replacement, finger replacement, where I slide my pinky on this C sharp because I'm getting ready to do the high C sharp. So see that? See how smooth that was? So I hit it initially. Well, yeah, I actually did my middle finger, all right? And then I get my pinky in place so I can spread my hand to cover this C-sharp with my thumb. And so the next thing after the lead-in is C-sharp and then high C-sharp. And then we go G-sharp. And then I like to add this little subtle feel. I do C-sharp to D-sharp. It's like a... It kind of adds a little soul to it. So... This is what we have. Okay? And then after you land on this C sharp, after you do that, we're gonna do both G sharps, okay? And so you can either do these double hits three times, like one, two, three, four, five, six, and then jump right back to the C sharp. Or you can do them two times and then do that lead in again. One, two, three, four. Na, 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 na. Okay? So that's what the left hand is doing for your chorus and for your intro, the intro and the chorus, all right? Now, when you listen to the song closely, the bass line, he does different lead ins, all right? I'm not gonna teach all of them because I think it's like seven different melodic phrases that he does, okay? But the main one is this one. This is the main one that he does the most, okay? He has other ones that you'll listen to, and you'll even hear it when you click on the video to just check the song out if you've never been familiar with the song or if you never noticed what the bass line is actually doing, all right? Listening to the details of that, all right? So now let's go to section one, the right hand. So we have some chords with the right hand. First, we have a four-note chord. The first chord is an E major 7. So we're doing E, G sharp, B, and then D sharp, okay? And so this is the timing just to give you a little bit of reference. So it's like two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one. And then right after this, when we get ready to do those double hits, you're going to double hit with this F sharp chord. But here's the difference. If you listen to the details of what the music is doing, they actually don't hit with the right hand. They only hit with the left hand the first time they do it. So they just hold this F sharp chord while we. Then they go back. And then the second time they double it all. Okay, so those are the small details in the song that when you study the song, you'll kind of notice, okay, every other time they do the double hits with the right hand. So the first time they just hold it. All right, so again, those are the only two chords you got. All right, and then we have one more chord right before we go into the verse, and I'm gonna show you that. So you got this E major 7, you gotta learn, and then this F sharp. All right, so if you are intermediate, advanced, and professional, you know that's real easy. Beginners, this might be new to you. Major sevens, you might have only been playing triads and dominant chords, but this is a major seven chord, an E, and then you have 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. This is the seven. This is what makes the E a major seven. All right, when you're talking relative to the E scale. Okay, now, so again, the third chord right before we go to the verse is going to be this. The left hand is going to do a B and a D sharp. The right hand is going to do a F sharp, A, B, and another D sharp. So the D sharp needs to be on top. The B on the bottom, the D sharp on top, and then you fill it in with a D sharp, a F sharp, and a B. So in the order, D sharp, F sharp, A, B. Okay, so let's do it all in time, and I'm gonna do it slow. 1, 2, ready, go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. And hold that. 2, 3, and 4. So you hit this on the and of right before 4. Okay? That's when we hit that chord. And then that's going to lead us into section 2 in just a second. So again, that I'm going to do that last go round. All right? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Got it? Okay. So if you need to work on that, that's kind of hard for you. If you're a beginner and that's kind of hard, you want to take it slow. That's all. Just take it slow. Every musician, when they're learning something difficult, we always take it slow. We learn it slow. We get it. We digest it. And then we're gradually speeding it up to normal speed. All right. So now let's move to section 2. Let's do the verse. Okay, after we do this verse, you got the whole song learned. Okay, so our first thing that we're doing with the left hand, let's divide section 2 up in the left hand and right hand as well. I like to simplify it that way. So first we have an E, a E and B, okay, in the left hand, and then we're gonna have a B and D sharp. And then the third is going to be an F sharp and a C sharp. So first we're doing a perfect fifth of E. Then we're doing a third, a major third for the B with the D sharp. And then we have another perfect fifth, but it's the F sharp perfect fifth. Okay. All right. And that's it. So we're just going to repeat that. All right. I think it's about 8 bars, if I'm not mistaken. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, it's 8 bars. Yeah, just kind of counting in my head. And so now the right hand, you're going to do. Now you have 2 ways you can finger this. I have a way that I finger it, but I'm going to play 4 notes. And this is how I usually play the 4 notes. The right hand is doing F sharp, G sharp, and I use my thumb, the side of my thumb, the cover bow, and then B, and then E. Okay, so that's the first chord that goes along with the E perfect fifth. See that? It has a nice sound. We call it an E chord, E major chord with an added second. This is your second E, one, and then two. That's the second of E. Now you can finger that where you can do thumb, index, and then use your middle finger, and then get your pinky along the other side. I don't like doing that. All right. I like actually using my thumb because it frees up a whole nother finger if I want to add some more notes on top. So I like to do this. That way I have the option to where if I want to, let's say if I really want to jazz this up, then I can do it. And I still have those two notes covered with my thumb. All right. So that's just a little side note, little side tip. So that's the first chord. Second chord. You have a B. Okay, so you're doing the third, and then you can either do four notes in one hand, or you can actually go back to the left hand where I showed you, and you can just do three notes in the left hand. The B, D sharp, F sharp, and then you do the exact same thing in the right hand. B, D sharp, F sharp, just to kind of beef it up. Okay, but the F sharp needs to be on top. Okay, so first chord and then second chord, and this all this is a B major chord. And then next we have the F sharp. Okay, so you have the F sharp perfect fifth, but in the right hand you're doing F sharp, A sharp, C sharp, and then you combine that with the perfect fifth. And the way you want to do it, you want to learn how to add soul to it. So you want to use the second, and that second and slide to the third. So, and then you will even hear the EP do that look like a F sharp, G sharp, A sharp. But they do it in such a nice, soulful way. So again, one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, one, two. Like that. Real nice, real soulful. So we do that four times, and then right back to section one. I love this groove. It's just such a nice groove. Oh, I hit that chord too quick. It's my bad. Hold, two, and three, and. Oh, and. That's right. I slipped on the E. I made a mistake, but it should have been this D sharp. So when we do that B, getting ready to go back to the verse, yeah, my pinky slipped off of it. So that's a mistake. And I'm going to leave that in the video, all right? Because I make mistakes too. We're all learning. We're continuing to learn, okay? And then we go back to the verse. And so if you want to know that little ad-lib, that's an A sharp and an F sharp. And then I go to B, G sharp, and then I go to C and A, and then I end on C sharp, A sharp. And so you can go up and stay up, or you can go up and go back down. All right, it's just a nice little soulful ad lib, simple what you can do in B when you're over that five chord, which is this F sharp. And so once you learn this, you got the song learned. That's it. That's the song, y'all. It's just a nice couple of grooves. You got section one groove, that intro and that chorus, where you can just play it all day. It feels so good. And then you got the verse groove that's so soulful, and then Teddy P voice singing on top of it. Man, that's what makes it a classic, man. It's just an awesome song, okay? So I hope this breakdown has helped you to know exactly what's going on in the song. Like I said, I know I didn't break down all of the bass lines because there are seven other melodic bass lines that lead into this C sharp that I didn't really go over. I'm kind of keeping in mind my beginner people, intermediate people. I don't want to overwhelm you with too much, okay? And so with that being said, I want to get you all ready for the full performance of Love TKO by Teddy Pendergrass. Thank you for your time. Thank you.